So how was your week? Did everybody have success registering a username?
The virtual community of eBay has its own university, and Bobby Miller is one of its authorized education specialists. What began as a hobby selling her own collections has turned into a second income selling pretty much anything.
Yankee Candles, when they stop making a scent, like leather.
She has her students dip their toes into eBay by bringing in things of their own they might want to part with for a price.
I bought them at a resale shop in Florida because I used to dress like this.
And so now you want to sell them again?
I want to sell them again, yes.
A lot of the students I have are first time, they're just learning how to get on eBay to begin to sell. So a lot of them have maybe items they've had from their parents or grandparents they want to sell, or they're just like me, they wanted to start out and make some extra money. So they're selling things from their homes.
I was curious myself, so that old box I'd had packed away in my basement for some 20 years became one of the teaching tools. We posted it together as a class.
We did the research on this. It's a round wooden box with nails. And they go for around $40 to $60. So that was exciting to find that out. So what I'm going to do is use the actual eBay site. And earlier today, I did a draft of the listing so we can go through the actual sell your form with that item.
Miller had taken four pictures of the box so potential buyers could see it from any angle. She described it in concise bullet points.
So box is in excellent condition. Wood is solid, lid fits nicely. Some of these I took from other listings of like, oh yeah, I should put that in.
In essence, she demonstrated how to finally launch it onto eBay.
Here, this is important to specify how many days you're willing to wait for payment. What I say is I'll wait 3 business days so my auctions end on Sunday and I want payment by Wednesday. I also say I highly recommend insuring your item. You can require it, but you know I'm not going to for this. Then I thank them for shopping. And I put my username again, you gotta do the marketing.
Everyone's curiosity items got walked through the research process using something called TerraPeak that details how things have sold in the past 90 days. Those used Chanel shoes a woman brought in, there were about 2,000 pairs sold in that time at an average $300, plus a few surprises.
Wow, look at that, one pair sold for $2,000?
Reality doesn't always meet expectation, as was the case with a set of Balik china dishes.
If it was $1,000, you might be more tempted, right?
Exactly. Right now it's more sentimental value.
One woman brought in a collection of what she called Coca-Cola tokens she'd had for at least 30 years.
This one, it's dated, this one. Good for one free bottle, 1915 to 16, and then they're all embossed on the back. Isn't that kind of cool?
They look like that.
Yeah. Wow.
Those went for $78.
The relative ease of research can help people discover what they have, especially when they really have no idea what it is.
I believe this came from vanity, possibly my great-grandmother's, but I don't know what it is.
Selling on eBay has made lots of people rethink the value of what takes up space. Deciding to part with things like sets of glass salt cellars can feel like being paid for a sort of spring cleaning.
It's not serving me any good, but somebody else might really like it, and I could use the money to put aside. That's really what I'd like to do as a seller, is just take that money that I make and put it aside. Something for my kids, something for a rainy day, just with things being unpredictable, a little extra something.
Okay, now we're going to talk about after the listing closes. What you do if your item sells or if it doesn't sell.
Once it's posted, there's a certain thrill to watching the bidding process as it unfolds. My little round wooden box started at $9.99 on Tuesday night. By Sunday night, there had been 14 separate bids and finally sold to a woman from Ohio for $76. After the 35-cent posting fee and a small percentage of the selling price that eBay takes, I netted over $70. Kind of fun taking the plunge into eBay.
So you must sort of look at the world differently now.
I do. No matter where I go, if I travel or in stores, I'm always looking to see what would sell well on eBay. And my friends and coworkers know that too. But that's how I look at everything.